Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and in this tutorial I will show you that how you can trigger animations on mouse click in Microsoft PowerPoint. And to illustrate this, I have created this animation here, which is inspired from one of the animation by Dario Corsi at codepen.io. So you can see this animation here. When we click on these boxes, then they drop down. And here one thing you can notice, that when I hover my mouse over the one of these boxes, then first it gets on top and also get larger, and when I click on this box, then it fall down. So this technique has been used on all the boxes, the same technique. So I try to illustrate the same in PowerPoint, however the effects are not exactly the same. There are a few things that you cannot do in PowerPoint, so let me show you. Here we have this presentation, and if I run this presentation and start clicking on these boxes, then they start falling down. But there is one problem here, that when I hover my mouse over one of these boxes, then they don't get on top of the other boxes on the screen. So we only have one choice here, that if I click on this box, then it will get zoom a little bit and then will fall down. So there is no mouse over effect in my presentation. Later I will show you that why we cannot apply mouse over effect in this illustration. And if any of you know how to use Visual Basic Codes in PowerPoint, then let me know if you can bring these boxes on top by hovering the mouse over them. So let me show you that how I have created this presentation. And for that, first I will go to File, New, Blank Presentation, and will change the layout to blank. And first of all, here I will insert a shape, a rounded corner rectangle, and will draw the rectangle. And we will go with this default yellow pointer. We will not change the shape as we want it like this. And then instead of choosing the fill or outline colors, you can also click on this shape style drop down button, and here I will choose this one with shadow. And now I will place this shape right here, zoom out a little bit, and now I will apply all the animation that I want to trigger when someone click on this shape. And for that I will go to the animations tab, click the add animation drop down button, and here first I will choose the bro shrink animation, set it to play with previous with a duration of 0.25 seconds, very short duration I am giving to this bro shrink effect. And now I will open the animation pen and will double click on this effect to open the effect options property window, and now I will change the size to 115, let's say. And I want this button to grow on both sides, and if you want to grow the size horizontal alone, then you can choose this option here, hit the OK key. But we want to run this animation when someone click on this shape. So now let's say I change the time duration to 2 seconds and see the slideshow. Now you can see that it has started growing automatically because we set it to play with previous with a duration of 2 seconds. So when I run the slideshow, then it immediately start growing to 115%. So I want to trigger this animation on mouse click. So you can do this just by clicking on this trigger button and then choose on click off and then the shape name on which you want to trigger this animation when you click that shape. So I want this animation to run only when someone click on this button. So you can do this by clicking on this trigger drop down button and here point to on click off, and there you will see the shape name. So before going further, I will recommend you to open the selection pane from the home tab and then give a proper name to your shape, like I give it box 1, and then hit the enter key. And now if I go again to the trigger settings, then here you will start seeing the name. So if there are many shapes on your slide on which you want to apply the trigger setting, then I will advise you to use the selection pane to rename each of the shape. So I am going to trigger this animation on click of box 1. Now this grossing effect will only play when someone will click on this box 1 shape. So let me show you if I see the slideshow. And now if I click on the shape, then it will start growing and will take the time you set in the time duration. So I will again set it to point, let's say half a second. Now I want to apply more animation to this shape. So the next animation will be motion path, and I will move to more motion path and will apply down motion path. Hit the OK key and hold down the shift key while adjusting the length of motion path. And I will drop this box right here out of the slide. And I also want to trigger this animation on click of box 1 and want to set a duration of 1 second and want to play this animation with previous. So when I will click on this box 1, then the first effect will run and it will increase the size of this box. Then immediately along with that, it will also start falling down. So if we see the slideshow and I click on this box, then you will see it will start growing and falling down at the same time. So I want a little bit delay and I will add a 0.50 seconds delay. So it will grow and then it will fall. And I also want to spin while it falls. So I add another animation, the spin animation effect, and set the effect option to half spin. Trigger it on click of box 1 and set a duration of 1 second. And also set it to play with previous with a delay timing of 0.50. So now when I will click on this box, then all these three animation effects will run together. Let's see the slideshow and then click on this box here. Right. So now I will start duplicating this box and will fill out entire slide. So the easiest way to make duplicate is to hold down the control and shift key while dragging and dropping the shape. So that way it will quickly create a duplicate. And now you can start pressing F4 key to replicate the last command. So that way you don't have to drag and drop again and again. You can just tap F4 key to make further duplicates. So now we have one line ready. And if you want, you can then select all of these shapes by pressing Ctrl A key, and then you can adjust the position like this. Okay, now see the slideshow and then now start tapping on any of these buttons and they will start dropping. But there is a problem that if I mistakenly click on the empty area of this slide, then it ends the slideshow and I don't want this. And I also want to display some kind of text or a picture in the background, so I will insert a picture here, insert pictures from this device, and I will choose this one and will send it to back. Now I will fill the entire slide with these button and will make duplicate of all these buttons here. So I will zoom out a little bit and will select all these buttons. And for the time, you can also hide this picture or can insert that picture later. Or you can go to the selection pane and then just hide this picture. So now I will hold down Ctrl and Shift keys while dragging and dropping these boxes to the right. And now start tapping F4 key to make duplicates. And now I will turn on the picture. I would also like to apply a hyperlink to the picture, because if I see the slideshow and start tapping on these buttons, and by mistake if I click on this picture here, then again it will end the show. So what I will do, I will hide all of these boxes and will just turn on the picture and will select the picture and will also apply an action setting. And we want nothing, we don't want to move to any other slide or the same slide. I want just to highlight the click. That way it will not do anything else but will just highlight the click. And on top of that, there are a lot of boxes, so you will not see the highlight click. and it will do nothing if by mistake someone click on the picture. Hit the OK key and then click on show all to see all the buttons. And now you can start clicking on this button to reveal the background picture. So that was all, but I also want to clarify a few more things, like we can't apply the mouse over effect. So if you select one of these shape and go to the animation pan, and here in the animations tab, if you click this triggers drop down button, then you can see that we only have the option on mouse click. We don't have the option on mouse over or mouse hover. That I want to grow the size of this box when someone hover the mouse over it. So you can't trigger a mouse over or mouse hover effect in PowerPoint. However, there is another option we have, and that is to insert an action setting, and then you can choose a macro that can run a particular animation on mouse over. Like we have both of these settings here, mouse click and mouse over, and you can set to run a macro which will have a visual basic commands that will trigger the animation effect and will and can grow the size and can even apply the motion path and spin animation effects together in a one macro script. So I don't know Visual Basic, but however I would like to show you something here. And here we have a macro. I have given the link of this website in the video description. I have given the link of this presentation in the video description. You can go and download this presentation, and you can also find a link to this website where someone is asking that he want to bring a shape on top when someone hover on that shape. So here someone replied and gave the answer that he should use this script in Visual Basic to bring the particular shape on top, like you have seen in this animation. If I move hover over any of these boxes, on whichever box I will hover, that box will get larger, and when I will click on this box, then it will fall down. So let me quickly show you that how you can apply Visual Basic codes. Let's say I select this code and right click and choose copy, and here in PowerPoint I just press Alt plus F11 key to bring the Visual Basic editor. And here I will insert a module and will paste that code here. Now close this window and now select one of these boxes, like this first one, and go to the insert tab, then click action. And here I can choose either mouse click or mouse over, and then I will choose run macro. And here you can see the name of the macro that we just saved in Visual Basic Editor, bring to front. So hit the OK key. And now if I will see the slideshow and will click on this box, you will see that it will get on top of all the other boxes on the slide. So you have seen that that box is now on top. Let's say if I click on this one. So first I have to apply the action setting on this one as well. And that is from fifth column, and that is the sixth button. So I will insert action. Run, and this time I choose mouse over, run the micro, bring to front, hit the OK key, and from the fifth column we will choose the sixth box, this one. So you see, as soon as I move my mouse over this box, it get on top of all the other boxes. So you have to insert this code in the beginning when you have created the first box and have applied the animation effect, and after that just insert the code and apply the action setting, and then start duplicating the boxes. So that way the action setting will also get copy along with that. So let's say if I make a duplicate of this first button here, so let's say if I make another duplicate of this first button here, select the button and go to home tab and then choose copy and then paste, And now if I go to the action, then you can see that the action setting has also been copied along with the shape. So there is a problem with this method, or you can say there is a problem or the code is incomplete, because now if I click on the first button, then it will get on top. But now I want to run the animation, or I want to trigger the animation, the three animation effects. But as I am clicking on this button, it is not triggering the animation. So if you know the Visual Basic, then you can add the animation effect codes to the same script. So if someone hover the mouse over this box, then it will get larger, and if someone click on this box, then it will drop down, and it will also get on front of all the other boxes. But anyway, you can't do this right now without Visual Basic code. So I hope you will find this trigger animation setting useful. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.